Hey, what's going on, brother? Thanks for checking in. Hey, got a special one for you. I brought in a special guest with me today. I got the man, Scott Leech. He's our strength and conditioning coach here at the University of Rhode Island, bringing him in to go over a in-season workout split. I've been to a lot of programs, and here, guys are getting bigger, stronger, faster, still even a couple weeks into the season. So I'm gonna let him take you guys today, get you on the whiteboard, show you a perfect in-season split. Stay tuned, brother, check it out.
What's up, brother? This is Scott Leech. You guys can't laugh. Hey, what's going on? Scott Leech over at the University of Rhode Island. Been here a little over a year. Had a chance to work with these dogs. It's been an absolute blast. They come in and get better every single day. Love that about them. One of the things going on this year is we're dealing with a lot of different changes due to Corona. That being said, we need to make sure that our game plan for in-season training is smart. So we had to make some adjustments. So we're gonna take you through a little bit of how to set up an in-season. The biggest thing when training in season is knowing that things are gonna change, things are gonna be different, the schedule from week to week may differ. If you know what's important to you and you make sure you get those things done every week, you're gonna be in good shape. Personally, we wanna make sure we're getting our speed work in every week. I think speed is the ultimate expression of power, athleticism, so we gotta make sure we're touching that. Always gotta make sure we're trying to get some power work in during the week. And then lastly, we don't wanna lose our strength in season, so we're gonna make sure we try and touch that every week as well. Give you a couple examples of how we're gonna set that up, assuming that we have a midweek game on Tuesday and then a three-game series over the weekend. So for our starting pitcher, let's say they start on Friday. Not a big believer in doing things after the game. As soon as the game's over, start that recovery process. No need to go in and get some extra work done. I just think at that point, it's time to recover. We'll use the next day, Saturday, to get a regen circuit in, and we'll talk about that after we go through the breakdown of what a typical regen circuit may look like. And then Friday, depends on where you are. So if we're home, we'll try and get our Sunday lift in. That's gonna be kind of a strength dominant day, more bilateral in nature, but definitely our strength work. If we're on the road, that just may end up being an off day just due to the game three and then travel afterwards, not getting access into a facility, especially right now during COVID. It's hard to get into a weight room on the road. So if we're home, let's get that lift in. If not, we're gonna have to wait on that one. Not a big deal. At the college level, Monday's a mandatory off day. So no matter if you're a starter, if you're a backup, we take Monday and Monday's off day. So have to play around that, have to work around that. If we got our strength work in on Sunday for our home series, then our starting pitcher is gonna get some power work in. Ideally, I like doing those things right after throwing a bullpen. Usually here we use our bullpens on Tuesday to get ready for the weekend. So for that guy, get his bullpen in, come in, get his power work in right after that. If we didn't get a chance because we were on the road to get our strength work in, then we just have to adjust the schedule. So Tuesday is gonna be our strength work and we'll put our power lift in on Wednesday. Knowing that, our strength work is gonna be a little different on Tuesday than on Sunday. Sunday you can go a little bit harder because you know you have Monday off. Tuesday, you can't really do that. So for our pitchers, if they got that Sunday lift in, they have Monday off, Tuesday is gonna be our power session. Wednesday can be a lighter day. Usually after throwing a bullpen, after getting that power work in, we wanna keep that Wednesday a little bit lighter of a workload. If they wanna come in and do some things just to feel good, a little bit of resilience work, totally okay with that. If we were on the road, we didn't get that strength lift in until Tuesday, then Wednesday is gonna be our power lift there. Faster loads tend to be a little bit more unilateral in nature too, but that'll be our Wednesday for them. Thursday across the board, if we're getting ready to start on Friday, is gonna be a primer session. We'll talk about that in a little bit of what a typical primer session is gonna look like to get ready and feel good and feel explosive going into the weekend. For our hitters, somebody who's gonna be there every day, schedule's gonna be a little bit different. So obviously they're gonna start on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So there's not really much we can do. If, again, we can get that strength session in on Sunday, if we have a home series, let's get that in after the game. Not always feasible, totally understand that. People have a lot of responsibilities. Maybe the family came up all the way from across the country, totally understand that. But if we can get some strength work in on Sunday, knowing that we have Monday off, let's take advantage of that, let's get that in. From there, they're gonna start again because we're in this scenario, have a midweek game on Tuesday. So we're gonna have to bump our strength work over to Wednesday. So we're gonna use a blend of strength and power exercises, knowing that, hey man, this person's gonna probably start four games this week. We need to make sure that our program doesn't drop them into a hole, but we do want to get that strength and power work in every single week. If we got our strength work in over the weekend, we can adjust this program and make it a little more power focused, take some of that strength work away because we already got it covered, which is a nice benefit of getting that lift in at the end of a long series. Again, Thursday is going to be a primer day. This is where we're going to touch our speed work as well. So we're going to get, you know, that little bit of speed work we need every week. We'll hit that on Thursday, leading up into a three-game series on the weekend. So let's say our pitcher started on Friday, you know, 8 innings, shutout, lights out, love that. Saturday, we got to get some regen work in. How we'll set that up, and this works great whether you're at home or on the road, typically the circuit's going to look like this. We're going to put an exercise to elevate heart rate. Whether that's a bike, that could be a light sled push, that could be jump rope, something that's gonna elevate our heart rate. We'll then go into a mobility exercise. We'll target T-spine mobility, hips, ankles, things that we may individually address based on that person and what they need. We'll add some soft tissue in between, partly to kind of lower that heart rate, bring it back down a little bit, but also give them a little bit of a breather here while getting soft tissue work in that we're gonna need. And then we'll pick a core exercise as well. We'll hit anti-flexion, anti-extension, anti-lateral flexion, anti-rotation. We'll hit all aspects of core. So we have those four exercises: heart rate, mobility, soft tissue, and core. We'll rotate through that 3 times. So every time is gonna be different. So if we did jump rope first, the second time will be maybe a light sled push. Third time could be a bike. Maybe 10, 15 seconds on those. Mobility, first time through might be T-spine, second time through might be hip mobility, third time might be ankle mobility. Same thing with soft tissue, same thing with core exercises. So all in all, there's 12 things we'll need to do, and we'll cycle through those 12 exercises for about 30 to 45 minutes, depends on how we're feeling that day. Again, just to get some good blood flow in there, get the mobility work that we need, attack the soft tissue areas that we should work on, and always improving our core. That's gonna get us back on track to have a great Sunday and then start the next week off right. For our Thursday primer session, we're getting ready for a game on Friday. We wanna feel fast, we wanna feel explosive, we wanna feel like we're ready to compete. What we'll do is we'll set a circuit up of high intensity exercises paired with some lower intensity exercises. We'll start with mobility to attack the areas that we need to work on, whether that's T-spine, hip mobility, ankle mobility. We'll then pick a med ball drill. We'll pick a variety of different med ball drills just to feel that attack nature and blast through the med ball. Again, we'll use a little bit of core work in there, not too much, but just enough. And then some plyo exercises, again, to work on the explosiveness. We'll take all four exercises, we'll rotate through. So first time, if we do T-spine, the second time we'll do hip mobility. If we did single leg plyos, maybe the second round will be double leg plyo. Or if we went linear, the second time through, we'll go lateral. And we'll take that 12 exercise circuit and we'll go for about 15 to 25 minutes on that. Just depends on how much time we have that day. Not a ton of work needs to get done on Thursday. We just need to feel good going into the weekend.
All right, so there it is. Hey, thanks for checking in. Scott's gonna be in a lot of videos in the near future. He's the man. And if you haven't, go ahead and subscribe for me. Gonna start posting new videos on the channel every week. We'll catch you next time.